please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
A very good morning. Welcome to Chartbusters. Well, this is a show where we'll highlight a whole host of buzzing stocks. As we speak, the Nifty is trading in the green. In fact, we're up close to around 30 points. So things are looking good. Remember, we're getting into a big weekend as Karnataka goes into vote. So, you know, besides looking at the Nifty, keep an eye out on the IVs as well. On both sides, they're moving higher. So it's a bit of a rarity, you see. When the Nifty is trading in the green, you have the India VIX as well that's trading more or less flattish or mildly in the green. Normally, they don't move in the same direction, but this time around, in fact, they are ahead of a big event. And then after that, you'll see the IVs coming off, and then you'll see the VIX cooling down as well. Hey, Mangalam, morning.
Absolutely, Nigel. You speak about the VIX. You know, at the start of the series, the VIX was at the closest, at the lowest that we had seen in 2018. So in the last six, seven sessions, where the Nifty has been absolutely flat, barring today's move, the VIX has actually surged about 12-13%. So that is something we'll have to watch out for. The mid-caps, they're underperforming. PC Jewelers, one stock that should come out, come on your screen right now, that is off about 22-23% off the highs. Remember, those looking to tender into the buyback, lock in that arbitrage by selling in futures, cannot do so because the stock is in F&O band. So that is what is causing the stock to fall. And now it's below the break-even price for retail investors as far as the buyback math is concerned too. But what is up is the consumption space, Asian Paints as well as Nestle, both of them at the high point of the day. We'll talk about that. First up, all the top stories of today. Consumption is the flavor of this morning. Morning trade with Asian Paints and Nestle, both of them surging higher by 5%. Asian Paints on the back of double-digit volume growth in their Indian decorative business. Titan's jewellery business division sees a 400 basis points margin expansion, while Nestle's profits grew 40% on the back of strong margin expansion too.
And Ujjivan hits a 52-week high after reporting its best quarter in more than a year, with net interest income growing a stellar 76%. The management tells CNBC TV18 that they see a 30% rise in their loan book in the coming fiscal.
Union Bank cracks in trade after the lender posts its biggest ever quarterly loss, with slippages rising more than 140% in the fourth quarter.
And telecom stocks like Bharti as well as Idea take it on the chin after Reliance Jio launched all-time low postpaid tariffs starting at around 199 rupees a month.
PC Jeweler, that one is off the high point of the day. The company has announced a 424 crore buyback at a price of 350 rupees a piece. Promoters will not be tendering in their shares in this buyback.
Okay, just focusing on Chennai Petro, actually, I think we should pull up today a chart of that stock, and I'm going to request my director to also pull up the futures plate of Chennai Petro. Now, intraday, the stock has recovered from the low point of the day. I'm looking at all three futures contracts. So you pull up, you know, the current contract, that's the May contract, the June contract as well as the contract. They've declared a dividend of around 18 rupees yesterday. So ideally, the trade would be you buy cash and you short futures, you know, to make for that particular dividend of around 18 rupees. But now, in fact, all three contracts that are currently there, that's the May, the June, as well as the July, excellent work. You know, we've got almost all the three contracts up there. All three contracts are trading at a bit of a premium. That's because what the company is saying is that they'll declare the record date after the AGM. Okay. I was looking at last year, and the AGM is a few months, you know, after after the results. So as of now, the sheet is reading it that the record date will be after August, because the next three contracts, in fact, they're trading at a bit of a premium. If the street believed that the record date will come before that, then it would automatically adjust itself. The stock has recovered from the low point of the day. And I also just said, I'll point out this technical factor for all our viewers. Pull up the intraday chart of the stock. It's recovered from the low point of the day. 18 rupees is the dividend. Last year as well, there was a dividend of around 21 rupees also. Just keep an eye on that stock. It's recovered a considerable amount from the low point of the day. But how do you trade the Nifty then? 10,750. We're holding out there. Let's see whether or not we can build on from here. Ashwini, what's the call? Buy into the Nifty or second half, we'll see some nervousness creeping back into the markets?
Financials are outperforming, and something to note here is that NBFCs are coming back very strongly. So all kinds of NBFCs, whether housing or otherwise, and that is providing more strength to the overall sentiment on financials. So the bank Nifty, you know, you just had a fairly strong big bar on the upside. You know, this could have follow through because NBFCs have been beaten black and blue. So if they are going to come back, that's going to add to sentiment on the bank Nifty as well. Broadly, Nifty is range bound. But if there's one index which can break through, say, yesterday's high, it's probably the Bank Nifty. Having said that, individual stock, ICICI Pru is a buy with a stop of 454, target of 470. Bajaj Finance is a buy with a stop of 1840, target of 1910. And PNB is a sell with a stop of 91, target of 84.
All right, Ashwini, you've spoken about a lot of financials, but can't let you go without talking about consumer space today. You know, Nestle is up 7% at a record high. You have Asian Paints at a 52-week high, as well as Berger Paints, which is rising on the back of that. Do you think after a stellar rally, after the results, the stocks have moved higher? Is there more to go, or maybe those who are long should take some profits and those who haven't entered might wait for a correction?
See, not so long back, Nestle used to be forever at 65 to 6800.
Right.
So breakout has just happened. Hmm. And you get out of Nestle, what do you invest in? HCC? So, you know, there are hardly, you know, 25 stocks where, you know, demand is consistent and which consistently produce results. So I think consumer is going to be the space for this year, along with, you know, maybe financials.
All right. All right. Thanks so much, Ashwini, for joining in and filling us in.
Never the one who, you know, minces his words. He just goes ahead and says it. We enjoy that. Thank you so much, Ashwini. With that, we'll take a short break. Come back. We talk about results. Lauris Labs sulking in trade after reporting a mixed sort of fourth quarter numbers. We'll get chatting with Satyanarayanan A. Chawa. Let's just keep an eye out on the markets. They are at the high point of the day. Heavyweights participating. HDFC Bank at the high point of the day. And there you should have Reliance come up for you on your screen. Jio's announced a postpaid plan, but the investors are giving it prepaid gains. Reliance Jio is, in fact, Reliance is at the high point of the day, sitting with a gain of almost 0.5%. But one stock which is sulking in trade today, Lauris Labs, after reporting a mixed set of numbers in the fourth quarter. The revenues have come in strong. However, the margins and profit have taken a hit. To discuss this and more, we have Satyanarayana Chawa, founder and CEO of the company. Thanks a lot, Mr. Satyanarayana, for joining in. Now, in the fourth quarter, your revenues grew 17% versus FY18 revenue growth of about 8%. What kind of top-line growth can we expect in FY19? Will it be closer to the one that we saw in the full year or the one that we saw in the last quarter?
We expect the FY19 will be closer to the growth we have demonstrated in the last quarter. So we expect the FY19 growth will be in the lower teens.
Well, Mr. Chawa, your margins declined by around 300 basis points this quarter. We saw a dip on a year-on-year basis as well. What can you guide going ahead?
The EBITDA margins were down by 0.5%. That's mainly because we have spent more on units where we are not getting any revenue. For example, our formulation unit, we are not getting revenue, but we have added 100 more team members there. We have spent more on the development. We also had another unit, inaugurated Unit 4, where we had 170 people. So that expenditure was more than the previous year. Otherwise, our gross margins remained 48% like previous year. That is a very good thing to note. So despite of our growth and pricing pressure for APIs, and also the sourcing from China is also having a lot of challenges with respect to availability and prices, we're able to maintain the gross margins at 48%.
All right, fair point. So you say margins were impacted because one of the new plants came by. So what exactly is the revenue potential from this new plant? And are all your plants operational now? Because I believe you added a couple more in the last few years.
All units are operational right now. We have six units, 1, 3, 5 in one industrial zone, where all these units are giving positive cash flows from the operations, and 2, 4, 6 in another industrial zone where we expect two units will be cash positive this year. So that FY19 will be a transformative year for the company. Yeah.
Well, sir, among your best performing sectors are ARV, synthesis, as well as oncology. What kind of growth can we see in these segments if we're looking at FY19?
We expect to grow in most of the segments in FA19. We expect to grow in ARVs. We expect to grow significantly in oncology, like we have grown in the last financial year. We expect to grow significantly to high margin synthesis business, We also expect to grow in formulations. So by FY19, we'll see revenues from all units and significant growth from last year. The one point to note is we have geared up to deliver from all units. That's the very significant work we have done in the last financial year.
Right, Mr. Chawla, you know, I'm looking at your business foray and you have started entering the US by foraying into the generic formulation business. Now, is that prudent given that we hear of pricing pressures in the US from all the other pharmaceutical companies? Will your margins be impacted because of that?
I think what point we need to keep in mind is we are going into formulations based on our API strengths. Forward integration. Assuming we have, say, margins 48%, when we do formulations, we do get incremental margins. Whereas for the incumbents, their gross margins are going down because of the pricing pressure. For integrated players like us, when we go into formulations, we definitely expect improvement in our gross margins. One point to note here is our foray into formulations not only meant for US. We will go into Europe. We have filed dossiers in Canada. We have filed dossiers with WHO for ARVs. We have filed dossiers with South Africa. So our formulation foray is global. So US is, everybody is considering limelight, but for the company, our formulation foray is global.
Well, Mr. Chawla, looking at your top line, what percentage of your revenues come in from the United States?
Very, very negligible. We only launched our first product end of January. So we don't have significant revenues from US, but we expect three product approvals from US this financial year.
All right, Mr. Chawla, you know, you're talking about the impact on your margins being one-off and your revenues growing in early teens or mid-teens in the next year. So that's something that perhaps the street likes. The stock has recovered a bit from the low point of the day. So before we let you go, you crossed the 2,000 crore rupees revenue mark in FY18. Can you do, say, 3,000 crores in FY20? And what about the margins? Where do we see them?
I don't want to comment on the top line number, but I can tell you very clearly, by 2020, we expect our EBITDA to go to closer to 25% because of the efficiencies we generate within the system. Yeah.
All right, that's encouraging. 20 to 25% is what you're guiding us for. That's going to be quite interesting. Thanks so much, sir, for stopping by and giving us all those details. The stock has recovered from the low point of the day in terms of the guidance that the management just gave us. By the way, we were just talking about Chennai Petro. The stock has moved to the high point of the day. It's recovered closer on 3.5% from the day's low. So keep an eye out on that stock. And Auto Pharma as well. You know, remember yesterday, a lot of these pharma stocks, they got hit. We have President Donald Trump that's going to be addressing, you know, everyone today in terms of pricing on medicines in the United States. But some of these stocks, they are rebounding in today's trading session. So we'll keep an eye out on these stocks as well as Wellspun Enterprises. Yesterday, the stock did well. Today as well, the stock is running along. Even Wellspun India, yep. Both those two stocks, Mangalam, are doing quite well.
Absolutely. So let's do one thing. We'll take a short break. Come back. We focus on all these individual stocks and the markets. Stay with us.
Well, Mangalam has been telling us about Asian Paints numbers. That stock is sitting with the gain, but also pull up Berger Paints. That stock, in fact, there's a bit of a rub-off effect that's taking place. So there, both those two stocks have moved to the high point of the day. So keep an eye out on that space. Also, another stock is Mandana Retail. Now, that stock, in fact, has lost nearly around 7% today. For this week itself, it's lost nearly around 15%. And in the last 1 month, it's lost nearly around 25%. So that stock, nearly 30%, actually. Keep an eye out on that one. Move to the low point of the day again.
Yep, Nigel, and you're talking about losers. You know, can't keep your eye out of one stock. Hero Motocorp, that one should come up for you. You know, yesterday we got the press release that the Munjals will get Fortis. However, this has nothing to do with the listed company. But something that the street perhaps does not like. The stock is sitting at the low point of the day in another strong market. But with that, it's a wrap on Chartbusters. You stay tuned to CNBC TV18. Trading Hour comes up next.